Okay, so alright, so I rode to a different section of the railroad tracks. I've never ridden this yet. I'm going to see where it goes. Hopefully I can get a little ways on this. We'll find out. I've only ridden 0.7 miles and I'm already winded. Kind of out of shape right now. Anyways, here we go. As you can see, the trail's a little narrow as far as rocks and things like that go. So I gotta pay attention here. So fortunately, this section I'm going mostly downhill, I can tell, because I'm coasting pretty good. I'm trying not to slide off the edge here. I should have taken that little trail down on the right down there. It would have been a little bit safer, I think. Yeah, it's getting a little narrow here. I gotta watch my pedal on the left side on these. Yeah, I definitely should have been down below there. I think when I get a chance, I'll head on down. Here's a little bit too steep. Trying not to go too fast in case I do screw up. Funny because it feels like I'm barely going, but I'm actually going a little over 10 miles an hour. I have no idea how this is going to go. Hopefully it will. Make it to Shingle Springs. It's about 10 miles to get there on this trail, according to Google Maps. But being as that is so dang bumpy, I don't know. I have to see if my arms and wrists will hold up. I mean, it's really bumpy. I don't know if you can see it in the video because I've got image stabilization turned on. But yeah, it's real bumpy. So I'm currently behind the town of El Dorado. I guess I could pull in there real quick. Sure I'd get over there from here. I'm in people's backyards. I think I'll hold off on that. Oh crap. Whole mess of startup pistols here. Just got one in my electric unicycle tire the other day, so I really hope I don't get one here. C seen what happens when the tires go flat on these. The tire peels right off the rim. Makes for a quick exit off your bike. Again, I'm trying to ride carefully, slowly. Tire. So I don't think the camera's aiming at it, but I've gone about 1.9 miles now, 1.8. Here in a moment I'll check my camera, see what I'm aiming at. Okay, so I'm at El Dorado Road. That was quick. One fun thing about these things, you really go a long ways in a short amount of time. Alright, now I'm trying to see which side of the tracks I want to be on. Looks like this time I'm going to be on the left side. Let me verify what I'm looking at. Okay, so evidently on the camera you're looking at my speed and my assist level. You're not seeing distance, but I don't want to cut off the whole ride in the video, so I'm going to leave it this way for the moment. Got some traffic here I'm waiting for. Thinking I heard two. I guess not. All right, here we go. Yeah, that's quite a bump. If I had gone straight, there's a place where I wouldn't have made it. Right there. The trail actually quit right there. And I have to be careful here because I'm running over blackberries. Close to running over blackberries and trying to avoid them. Take the low road again, hopefully that's right. Since I really don't know. Okay, so I can tell you that the front suspension is helping, but this trail still sucks on the wrists. I'm also running 20 pounds pressure in the tires because I'm trying to get some mileage out of it. If I took it down around 10 or so, it'd probably help quite a bit. The way it's feeling right now, there's a chance I'm going to end up having to do that. Okay, more blackberries we got to be careful of. The trail I'd ride a little faster. I just don't know what's coming. I don't know if I got rocks, trees down, gullies, whatever, so I'm trying to pay attention. I am riding alone, so if I get hurt, I'm not going to have anybody to come get me. And I am on a lot of blood thinners right now, so falling down is not a great idea. Whoa, alright. So, I'm going to go through here. It's getting the trail quit over there. A lot of blackberries here. And a major hill. I can't see what's at the top. Alright. So this is Motherlode. I get across here and figure out which side of the railroad tracks I need to be on. Looks like the left side again. Kind of hard to tell because there's not a whole lot of trail here. But there's something. Dang, there's so many leaves I can't tell what I'm about to hit. Yikes. Some really loose gravel right there too. Yeah, my tires are a little bit too stiff, so the loose gravel's a little wobbly. Ah, dang. Tires are killing me. Alright, now I'm crossing over to the other side. There's more of a trail on this side for a little bit. Blackberry on the leg. I'd like to be looking around and kind of seeing where I'm at and enjoying the ride, but the trail is narrow enough, I really can't afford to look away. Catch a pedal or tire on the wood of the tracks there, I'm gonna screw up. I'm actually focusing decently on the trail. Okay, so I've now done 2.8 miles, 14 minutes. Crossing and a car coming. Oh, the trail kind of turns into nothing here, so we'll see. I'm hoping I get to make it all the way to Shingle Springs, but we'll see. I'm not into abusing myself, so if it gets too narrow, I'm gonna get beat up a lot. I'm just not gonna do it. Dry around here right now. It's terrible. Here's a jump. Uh-oh. Not sure if I should have come up here or down there. Well, for a moment here, but here again we got another bridge that I can't go across, so I gotta go down. Whoa. Alright, what's going on? Looks like I gotta go under the train, under the trestle. The other side. Oh gosh, hill's killing me. There we go. Yeah, this bike isn't a beast up a hill. It's quite a challenge actually. Dang. These tires are killing me. I'm gonna end up letting out a little bit here in a minute. I'm trying to think once I get there if I'm going to come back this way, if I'm going to go the road. The problem is the road doesn't have a shoulder most of the way, so it's kind of an issue around traffic. We'll see. Got a bunch of obstacles here, which makes it challenging and fun actually. Whoa. That bump didn't look as big as it was. Looks like I'm going the high road here. Hopefully I don't catch a bar and throw my stuff off the edge. I'm going to slow down a little bit because these trees are close enough. They're going to catch my mirror, tip me over. Ooh, that one again got me a little bit. Yeah, I really don't want to fall off here. It's a little ways down. I'd say it's about 15 feet down to the tracks. Nice steel track to hit my head on. down, got some tree roots. Yeah, quite sweet actually. But it's handling it. Oh, I should have gone. Whoops. I should have gone that other trail maybe. I'm off. Walking it up this because I don't have anything to pedal up that hill. Right. See what we got going down. Hopefully it's not too bad. It's kind of heavy. We're good. Skidding, but we're good. Trying to recognize where I am right now. Okay, this is, what do they call this road? And I'm gonna take a break for a second anyway, so I'm gonna look it up. Got my GPS running in the background. Yeah, Greenstone Road. What I was thinking. Man, I'm now gonna let a little air out of my tires. Problem is I don't have a gauge on me, so hopefully I don't do too much here. Didn't let out a whole lot, but I felt the sidewall go a little bit softer. See how that does. The rear. Trying to find a rock. This one doesn't stick out enough for my finger to push. Again, I just softened the sidewall a little bit. My guess is I'm still 15 or better. But I want to go a little bit at a time just in case. Alright. Oh, dang. I can see my video went all screwy. See if I can lock it a little bit tighter here. Yeah, I didn't catch that. Sorry about that, guys. Alright. That's too bad because I hit some pretty good hills there. Alright, so it looks like I'm going to be on the right side of the trail this time. Side of the tracks. You always want to be on the right side of the tracks, right? Yeah, but a little bit I let the air out. Quite a difference, actually. I know I didn't let out very much, but boy do I feel it. It's good to know, though, because I didn't want to go too low. For fear of peeling my tire off the rim. This is a nice section of trail here. Well, which one do I want? For anyone wondering about single trail or single path or whatever it was, yeah, the Sondors is just fine. I'm going down, it just feels a little safer than that up high thing on the railroad tracks, because again, if I fall down from there, I'm going to be in trouble. Ouch. Getting hit by that one. Yeah, it's a little challenge to get up. Whoops. No, I guess I'm right. Thought I was coming up to another bridge. So the trail goes left or straight along the tracks, huh? This time I'm gonna stay on the tracks. Looks like the trail is more used, so hopefully I don't hit a spot. But it's a big hole there. Hopefully I don't hit a spot where I have to turn around and go back. Honestly, I don't know if there are any bridges on this. I know there are some bridges on the tracks here, but I don't know if there's one this way or not. So, if there is, we're all going to learn about it at the same time. You know what? That trail over there is much better. Much more better. So we're, going over the tracks. Talk about windy. Although, you know what? I'm glad I didn't do this one, because that hill behind me is a really steep, long hill. I would have been walking up it, too. This section I was able to pedal up. Alright, pretty bumpy here. And a lot of rocks. As you can see ahead of me, there's a lot of rocks. So, let's try and power through it. Yeah, I almost caught my pedal there. Alright. Sondors did it fine. I think if anything's gonna break today, it's gonna be me. Crossing my fingers on that one. Crossing my fingers that neither of us work. Oh, that's a leg burner there. I feel like just did. Kind of hoping I hit a nice level spot here in a minute so I can just throttle it for a minute. Let my legs cool down. Just noticing some fresh bike trails or tracks, so I don't know if I'll meet up with somebody here or not. Holy moly. Ah, I didn't get enough run at this. Actually, if you can see it, there isn't enough run for this. Fortunately, the bike's carrying itself up this hill. I have to lug myself. Ooh. Sorry about all the heavy breathing. I took a wrong turn because the trail there goes on to private, crap, goes on to private land. So what I did there was I turned my wheel too far and it started going backwards. Too much side hill, I couldn't reach the ground. Alright, rock on one side, wood on the other. So I kind of know where I'm at now. I'm coming up on the Indian Reserve. A little bit before it, but I'm coming up to the Red Hawk Casino. Probably still half a mile from it, maybe a little bit more. But I know going along the freeway, I know where this spot is. Okay, so the trail's kind of trying to disappear here. I did see a truck go off to the left back there. I maybe should have been on it. Yeah. There we go. Although it's not much better. Actually, it's not any better. Yeah, that hurt my wrist just now. A couple of big bumps. But to go left here, there's no trail on the tracks. Some baby short horses, miniatures, horses with braids, all kinds of neat horses. It doesn't look very bumpy, but the grass is hiding it. It's really bumpy. Bicycle tracks sure look fresh. They look like the last thing that was here. They're on top of everybody's footsteps and everything. So I don't know if I'm gonna meet up with them or if it's, you know, been a couple of days. But it doesn't look like a couple day old tracks because they aren't worn off at all. They're nice and sharp still. We've been real dry lately, so tracks normally will wear themselves down a little bit over the days. I was a tiny bit sketched there. I had to pay close attention. I haven't been watching my battery, so I've done 5.8 miles and I've got, according to the gauge, which is almost iffy, I've got 3/4 battery left. Voltage, give me a moment and I'll check that. Ow! My left wrist is really hurting all of a sudden. I've got 39.4 volts. I don't know what that means. I'm sure some of you guys will know. Hard to hold a wheelie on this thing because it's hard to get it up high enough to get in your balance range, so it ain't heavy. It doesn't like to lift up like that. All right, now I'm around the star thistles again too, so hopefully I don't have issue there. Now, I do trails like this occasionally. I'm kind of surprised I haven't had a flat yet. Tires don't strike me as something that's very durable. I haven't put in the guard yet or the slime. I know, goofy me. But it's the way it is at the moment. So I hope I'm not missing something. All the shadows and leaves. Easy to miss something big. So far, so good. Alright, what do we got here? There's the gate. Alright, what road are we on now? This would probably be Ponderosa Road. Oh man, I am tired. So here in a minute, I'm gonna have to stop and take a water break. I'm trying to see which side of the tracks I wanna be on here. It's hard to tell from here. I think it's going to be the right side. Yeah, I thought I heard a truck. Here we go, I think. Trying to hear. Yeah, because the right side, cars are on me before I know it. Alright, so this is why it didn't look like much trail, since it goes over this way. Huh, I must have whacked something good. My fender was all turned sideways. They're hidden until you get right on them. That's the way they're behind the dirt. Dang it, I don't want to go up that one. But here we go. Come on, come on, come on. Nope, not quite. I maybe could have done it because it's not that much further. My legs are yelling at me already. Oh, and you know, I haven't even checked my heart rate. It's kind of silly. I had 2 heart attacks in March. I'm supposed to be watching that. In fact, I'm going to check because I feel it pounding pretty good. Oh, I'm at 150. Dang it. I'm gonna ease up a little bit. I probably shouldn't be running 150. I think my doctor would yell at me a little bit. I have a hard time riding slower because I enjoy it faster. But I don't want to fall down on the trail here. I'm up to another road here. Oh, actually, I'm just paralleling the mother load here. I might get some water and still running 150. Ah, dang it, 151. All right, I'm gonna get some water, trying to slow this down. Still have quite a bit of battery, 39.2 volts still, when I'm not running. Going 6.8 miles. But as you can see, it wasn't flat. Ah, dang, I'm a little uncomfortable, but it's going down. 147 now. Come on. Give the show. There we go. 147. All right. Drink about 2/3 of a bottle of water. I'm gonna slowly get going again. Let's see if I can keep myself slow enough. I can feel it. I need to take a break now. Figure out which side of the tracks is better here. It's pretty equal. Yeah, so I'm just gonna pedal nice and easy. Let the pedal assist help me along. Fun section of trail here. Whoa, really steep. Here we go. Not so much. Because of the angle, that was a little challenge to get off. Back on it. Well, strangely enough, I'm almost in Shingle Springs. I mean, I'm actually in Shingle Springs. Not to the town part of it. the LCD says I've only done 7.2 miles. I know my GPS says it's closer to 8. Not sure which is more accurate. I haven't really figured it out yet. Haven't done any tests. Oh, no hands for a minute. The rest of my wrist. Legs are burning. Pedaling pretty hard because I don't want to lose my speed. I have to push this thing. And I'm running out of steam. Time for a break. I know, huh? And I'm going to set my alarm. Anybody moves it, it lets me know. Okay, so before I change batteries, I just want to run up on it. This is how I'm mounting my camera, so I catch the LCD and the road. Of course, my LCD controller. Where my alarm remote goes. And I just set it off because I forgot I armed it. Got my headlight here. Of course my controller, this is where my cell phone sits. And I can hear it really well. Got my tour pack, my lock cable, fenders. I leave my switch open most of the time. I probably should have closed it because of all the dust. But I'll give this a good bath when I get back. Here's my headlight again. That headlight's really bright. And I have it so that I plug it into the USB port that I've installed here. So it's running off the main battery. I don't have to worry about recharging my little batteries on these things. I just leave it hanging right there. So that's it. I'm gonna switch batteries so I can take it back. And film the ride back. Okay, so I just spent about 20 minutes letting people take photos and ask questions about the bike. I think we got some more sales there just now. Avid bicyclist, and he's really excited about it. coasting right now, in case you're wondering. Just hit throttle. I'm going to take advantage of this for a minute. Rest a little bit more. I've got quite a few hills heading back if I stay on the road. I haven't decided yet if I'm done or not. I really love the fact that I have that mirror on the side. I can see these cars coming up behind me right now. Some of the places along here, there's not really much of a shoulder. So I know if I have to stop and get over, kind of tell if they see you, because they usually will kind of scoot over a little bit. Not always. It's gonna get me back towards the railroad tracks in case I decide to go that way. Up ahead, railroad crossing next to me. I was gonna ride the roads, but I honestly don't feel very safe on them. One problem is going back, I'm heading uphill quite a bit, so I'm hoping I can do this. If not, I'll go find another road and head back. Pedal assist a little bit. Fly is a little hard on these trails. There's a little too much punch when you don't want it. Guess I'm going up a hill, but then I can just boost it with a throttle. Four seems to be about right for me because I like to run anywhere from 10 to 18 miles an hour in the dirt. might be interested in trying a pogo suspension seat post. Then again, I kind of like, you know, feeling the bike under me. I've never tried one though, so I don't know. Maybe it'd be fine. I like feeling the control. I have a suspension mountain bike and it rides fine. And I'm not sure what it would be like on the pogo seat. Yeah, that was me looking to the right at a horse. So much cool scenery around here. You know, honestly, I should slow down anyways. I don't want to get my heart rate up again quite as high as I had it, because I don't know yet what I'm safe at. The doctor hasn't told me. I'm doing a stress test here shortly, and he's going to give me a number after that. If you're wondering, all that rattling is the turbo. I wanna check something. Alright. Thought I saw a part. I wanna make sure it wasn't one off of my bike. Ah, crap. What am I doing? There we go. Got on side saddle and I was kinda off balance a little bit. Yeah, the rattling you're hearing in the back is the tour pack. It's rattling so bad because I have a battery in it. I've got an extra battery on me. The battery itself is safe because I got it inside the bubble wrap that it was shipped in and then stuffed into the tour pack, so the battery's protected well. That tour pack does bounce around a little bit. Figure out how to tighten up that tour pack. That can't be good for it. I don't want the lash to break off or something. Not horses. That horse was wearing dreadlocks. brought the extra battery because Google was telling me it was about 10 miles to get to Shingle Springs. I figured having gone off-road like this, I'd probably be empty by the time I got there, pretty close. I've actually been pedaling almost the whole time, so it's not quite that bad. And it ended up only being, depends on what you read, 7-something on the LCD, 8.1 on the GPS. Oh. I'm a little winded, so I'm not even going to start up that hill. I want to try and catch it in the middle, so I'm going to let the bike push itself up and I will follow. As you can see, it's quite steep. Yeah, Sondors did it though. I had to give it a little push there actually. Not much, but a little. A little steep section. Remember coming down it. Oh, dang. I came down that one too. Which I'll know in a minute if I have to do it again. Yep. Okay, this one's as steep as the last one, but much longer. As you can hear, I'm spinning out back there. Trying to get up the hill. Come on, Sondors. Alright, well, this sucks. Still a ways up here. I think actually, I'm gonna do a U-turn. There's my trail. I came through here. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to go down to the low trail. Go back a little further. I'm going to ride the low trail this time. Because I'm tired, I would say I'm probably not as stable as I'd like to be right now. So, this is where I'm going to be. See a bad spot for rocks falling on your head. I'm really hoping I can avoid that. Yeah, so that rock and the railroad ties there are pretty high. They want to catch a pedal going in between. talkative, am I? Stop pedaling for a second because I didn't want to catch my pedal on that rock. Should have done that. Not sure if it would have cleared, but I think it might have. And back on. A little bumpy, so hang on tight. And steep. Yeah, I think if I let out just a little more air, it'd be a nicer ride and I wouldn't skid so much going down the hills like that. Just a reminder to anybody that's going to try that, don't go grabbing a handful of front brake on the way down one of those hills. Grab a heavy back brake, feather the front, let that front tire slide out on you. Won't be a happy day. Wrists are a little beat up to blasting through here right now. I'm sure coming this way I was going faster, but definitely feeling it now. Yeah, it was some big bumps. Shot my tire out about a foot. Take this turn instead. Nice. It's dang steep. I don't know if you can tell on the video, but it's dang steep. Just trying to keep it from going too sideways on me. Still really steep, but yeah, there my front wheel tried to bounce out sideways because I'm just running too firm of a tire still. Come on, Betsy, let's do it. No, I'm not making this one. I'm giving up now. I noticed that pushing up these steep hills, I'll do if I'm not on a long ride, but they tend to wear me out real fast. But I don't want to be stuck in the middle of the ride, not be able to finish. Okay. Time to cross the track. Turkeys. You know, let's ride the higher road. Other ones are safer. But I'm getting tired. Which I can tell because I'm a little wobbly here. I really shouldn't be wobbling here. Be a sucky place to fall down. Yeah, the tireder I get, the less solid I am on the road. Same thing if I'm riding a dirt bike. I gotta slow down later on in the day. course, dirt bike I can ride much longer. Alright. This is a little iffy, so I'm not going to be shy. I'm going to go really slow. Yeah, because I'm slowly sliding down that little ledge right there. There we go. That was a little ways down over there too. I don't want to go down. Frustrating because I'm looking at it, it's like I know I can do this, but I am tired. So I think it would be silly of me to do it. The bike would handle that just fine. I just don't think I'm gonna. Bike actually side hills really well. All the tread on the side of these tires, it does really good. But when it's loose gravel like that, there's not a lot that's going to hold you on the trail. That's why I'm slowing down a bit on the side hills there. Traffic. That's good. Staying on the low trail this time. Which might have been a mistake. No, I think I'm right. And now I don't really have much choice. I gotta go the high trail. Dang it. I don't want to climb that. I'm too tired. So even though I don't have a lot of choice, I'm doing this one anyways. Now I came down that one a bit. Sorry it's so bumpy, but I'm on the railroad ties part of the time. Story about these railroad tracks is one group wants to reclaim them as a railroad track, start running trains on them again. Another group wants to reclaim it as a bicycle walking path. It's kind of an ongoing battle about who's going to get them. And then the landowners around here just want it back. Like to have their property run out over it. There are sections of the trail that have already been turned into bike path, and the plan on that side is they want to run it all the way from Sacramento to South Lake Tahoe, which would be an awesome bike path, obviously. The deal is, as long as somebody keeps it, it can't go away. So they've kept the tracks here because as long as the tracks are here, landowners can't take it back. They kind of lock it up. If they turn it into a bike path, same thing, they kind of lock it up. So it remains either a bike path or a train track forever. Ouch. Just sprained my thumb a little bit. Easy one, but ow, that hurts. I lifted my hand just a slight bit and then hit a bump at the exact right time. That really hurt my thumb. Alright, here I gotta go underneath the train track. Hear the bars creaking because I'm grabbing a handful of handlebars. Alright, I could go straight, but it looks like it's leaning off to the side. There's no trail. And this one, it's not too steep. Jump, but more of a small wheelie. One thing I didn't do when I was stopped, which I planned on doing, was to check my axle bolts and make sure my tires weren't going to fall off on me. And I was going to inspect the tires for thorns and what have you. And I got neither of those things done. Just catching my breath again. Now for the record, there are still little trains that come along this track. They don't run full size anymore, but they have these little passenger trains that give rides along here on Sundays and once in a while during the week. But I'm in no danger of being run over by a train here. If I was, I'd be riding a lot more cautiously, although I am always looking in my rearview mirror as I go here. Even if a motorcycle or somebody comes up on me, I want to be sure and get out of the way. Here's a fun section of the trail right here. It's fairly smooth. It's got these little whoop-de-doos. It's kind of cool. Ouch. Just got a blackberry thorn in my shin. Yeah, I'm getting tired. That bump hurt my back just now. There's some loose gravel here, so I'm kind of wishy-washy back and forth a little bit. Manageable, but you can definitely feel it. So if I go left, it'll go right home alongside this road. And it is tempting. Like I say, the shoulder's not very good, but this time of day, I probably don't have a lot of traffic. I'm gonna cross the road here. Oh, my battery's just about done. You know, I think I'm gonna reprogram my LCD. I'm gonna open up my speed limiter. See how fast I can go. Hopefully my tires don't have any punctures. Alright, let's see. Power it down. Power it back up. The 4 or 5 seconds hold up and down. Goes into programming mode. I'm already set at 45. I didn't remember that, but I'm going to open it up all the way. And obviously going higher here doesn't really make any difference, but I'm going to go ahead and take it all the way up to 72. And there I'm programmed. Turn it off. Now, I'm going to end up draining this battery really fast. And then I'll switch over to the new one. But I'm curious how fast this thing will go. Let's see how many volts I got. Currently got 36.5 volts. Again, I don't know what that means. I should figure that out. I'm sure some of you people can help me out with that. I don't know what's full and what's all the way empty. Well, I guess I could just figure that out when I'm dead here. And then when I put the new one back in. But anyways, I've done 13.5 miles so far on this battery and on a pretty hard off-road trail, so I'm impressed with that. That's not bad. This is the 12.8 amp hour 36 volt bottle battery. The upgraded Sondors. Okay, so get my mirror adjusted. I definitely have cars here. Okay, now I'm on a nice flat spot. Fairly flat. I'm going uphill slightly, but barely. Yeah, it's actually uphill a bit. I can see it in front of me. Because I'm full throttle right now. So I'm going to go ahead and give it some pedal. Yeah, this battery just has no juice in it. Steadily climbing here, so this isn't a great place to be testing. I do have a car coming up behind me and cars in front of me, so I'm trying to get out to this spot here. There we go. Now I'm safe. Except for that big old pine cone. According to how I'm riding, how it feels, this battery's just about done, I believe. I'm gonna go ahead and swap it real quick. Dang, my bike is dirty. Really bad. Tour back and everything's filthy. Inside of the battery box a little bit, not terrible, but a little bit. Oh, I forgot to turn that off before I popped it. My bad. Like I was telling you, I store the second battery inside all the bubble wrap. Not sure what you're looking at. Let me see. Yeah, you can see it. So it's inside the bubble wrap. And then inside the tour pack there. That keeps it from being damaged. I'll swap it. Put the other one back in that bag. Fits into this tour bag real nice. Nice and cushioned. I'll probably buy something like a yoga mat or something, but a thick one, and build a little pouch for it. Okay, so the old battery, pretty much dead, was about 36 volts, somewhere in there. This one is 41.7. So probably 42 is fully charged. Now I'm going to find out how fast this will go. I know before I was able to do 24 miles an hour, throttle only. I believe it's 28 with pedal assist. So let's see what we got. Okay, throttle only. Yeah, there's a lot more pull to it. Doing so good. This is throttle only, but I remember I actually let some air out of the tires. I'm assuming that's affecting it somewhat, because I was running 20 pounds when I did it last time. I have a car behind me. I just feel like the bike is dragging more, so I'm not sure what pressure I got. I'd like to check when I get back. And I also really need to do the test on a flat area. I'm currently climbing uphill, and when I was going the other way, I was going downhill slightly. Definitely making a difference. Thank you. passing out because my heart rate's back up close to 150 again, and I'm really tired. Got a car coming up behind me, that's why I'm off-road. Oh, another one. Cool, because this, and I'm not recommending anybody do this. This tire grabs the edge of the pavement pretty good. Normally you wouldn't go on and off a little ridge like this. This tire doesn't seem to mind it very much. But again, I'm not recommending anybody do that. If it does catch wrong, it throws you down. Holy crap.